Good morning. In this session, we will discuss about the three-phase fault on an unloaded generator. Let us consider the same three-phase symmetrically wound alternator where all the three phases have short-circuited because it is a three-phase fault. So the current IA, IB and the IC currents, any node if you say apply the KCL, the sum of the entering current IA plus IB plus IC, there is no leaving current here. We don't have any path from this. So IA plus IB plus IC equal to 0. Let us consider that as a first condition. The second condition, if you see any other relations we can find from this, if you can see all these output terminals are short circuited, and if you see this side, all the negative terminals are connected together. All these three phases have become parallel to each other. That means the voltage with respect to the phase A and the voltage with respect to phase B and phase C all are equal to each other. So you can consider that as a second condition. VA is equal to VB is equal to VC. Now by using these two conditions, now we are going to find out the symmetrical component of the system. So current IA naught is equal to 1 by 3 IA, IB and IC, that is equal to 1 by 3 times of. So we know the IA plus IB plus IC current is equal to 0. So the 0 sequence current will be equal to 0 amperes. And coming to the positive sequence current, IA1 is equal to 1 by 3 times of IA plus A into IB plus A square into IC. To simplify this, we know the current IB, if you take the, since the system is a balanced system, so you can say take the phase sequence ABC. Let us assume this as a IA phase and this as a IB and IC we have seen already in the symmetrical transformation concept. So you can represent the current IB as A square into IA and the current IC, this IA has to rotate 120 degrees. For that you use operator A. So that is IC is equal to A into IA. So now you can represent IB as A square into IA plus A square into IC can be represented as A into IA, A into IA. So now if you simplify here 1 by 3, all the terms are having IA. So let us take that as a common IA into 1 plus A into A square, A cube. A cube value will be equal to 1. Again A square into A value will be A cube, that is equal to 1. So 1. So this 3 and this 3 will get cancelled. Finally, you will get the positive sequence current IA1 is equal to the phase current IA. Now coming to the negative sequence current, IA2 is equal to 1 by 3 times of IA plus A square into IB. I will substitute directly here itself. The IB value is A square into IA plus A into IC. IC value is A into IA. Now let us simplify 1 by 3. IA if you take common 1 plus A power 4. A square into A square A power 4. A power 4 value is equal to A. So A plus A into A is A square. Again we know 1 plus A square value equal to 0. So therefore the current IA2 value is equal to 0. So from this we know IA naught value is equal to 0, IA2 value is equal to 0. Only the positive sequence current IA1 is equal to the phase current. Now let us find the sequence components with respect to the voltages. VA1 is equal to 1 by 3 VA plus A into VB plus A square into VC. We know VA is equal to VB is equal to VC, because all are parallel to each other. So therefore this also can be represented by VA and this also can be represented by VA. So if you take VA common, that will be 1 by 3 VA into 1 plus A square, which will be equal to 0. So this VA1 value will be equal to 0 volts. Similarly, if you consider the VA0 and the VA2 terms also will have the same kind of relation. You will get 1 plus A square, but only the thing is the coefficients may be interchanging here and there. Finally, you will be getting the 1 plus A square term. Therefore, VA naught equal to VA2 equal to 0 volts. Now, if you consider this relation, VA1 is equal to, and we know VA1 is equal to EA1 minus IA1 into Z1. So, here, the VA1 is equal to 0 volts. If you substitute 0, 0 is equal to EA1 minus IA1 into Z1. And IA1 value is equal to, just now we have determined that is equal to the phase current IA. So, therefore, the phase current IA is equal to EA1 divided by Z1. So, this EA1 also can be represented by just EA because the induced EMF will produce only with respect to the positive sequence components. There won't be any induced EMF with respect to negative sequence and the zero sequence. So, therefore, specially you don't need to represent with the subscript 1. So, finally, we got the current IA1 is equal to IA which is equal to EA divided by Z1. So, this is one equation. Another condition you can say VA0 is equal to VA1 is equal to VA2 that is equal to 0 volts. So, finally we got the relation the current IA1 is equal to EA by Z1 and the IA0 value is equal to IA2 value is equal to 0. All the components with respect to the 0 and the negative sequence are equal to 0. Therefore, for the 3-phase symmetrical fault, we will have only the positive sequence components. So, what is the reason for this? Even though it is a fault, the fault currents in all the 3 phases are equal in magnitude and are displaced from each other by 120 degrees with each other. So, the system is still in the balanced condition. We know in a balanced system, we will have only the positive sequence components. We won't be having any negative and the zero sequence component. That is one point. Now, we are discussing about the shunt faults. In this shunt faults, the single line to ground fault, double line to ground fault and the line to line fault will fall under the unsymmetrical fault category and the 3-phase fault alone will come under symmetrical fault category. So, this I have explained already in the fault analysis itself. So, even before derivation also, that much concept we know. That is, this 3-phase fault is nothing but the symmetrical fault where the system will be intact with the balance condition. So, it will have only the positive sequence components. Now, let us represent the sequence network. So, coming to the interconnection of the sequence networks, we won't be having any zero sequence and the negative sequence. We will have only the positive sequence. So, that is Z1 and the current IA1. So, this is voltage EA1 or you can say EA and here VA1, VA2, VA0 equal to 0. Since it is a 0, these terminals are short circuited. This current IA1 is equal to IA. So, you can write IA1 is equal to IA that is equal to EA by fault current is equal to either the phase IA or IB or IC currents. So, we know already the phase current IA. So, this is nothing but the fault current. So, the fault current, 3-phase fault current is equal to EA divided by Z1. So, that's it. If you have any doubt, please comment. Thank you.